Tell your neighbor, you're looking at one. You're looking at one. You're looking at one. You have no idea what God has brought me out of. You can't even tell when you look at me. I've been in a season of miracles. This is... I cannot explain it. This may not make sense. I know what it looks like, but I choose to go against that. And I'm speaking something different. I'm speaking something different. Claiming something different. Expecting something different. Say,
I cannot explain it. This may not make sense.
I know
what it looks like, but I choose to go
and
against that.
I'm speaking something different.
I'm claiming something different.
Find somebody near you
something
and tell her this. Listen,
this week will be
a week for
miracles.
Tell them
this week
will be
a week for
miracles. Tell them
this week
will be
a week for
miracles.
Tell them
miracles.
Thank you.
is a place of love, hope, and healing. We are a real people with a real praise. Broken, hurt, lost, or in bondage, sick, or in
coming to you from the Greater Grace, where the Bishop James E. Jones Jr. is founder and senior pastor. This morning, family, I'm glad to be in the number. We had a good and productive week. I embarked in a fundraiser that I didn't know exactly what all I was doing, but it came out wonderful. And guess what, family? As you can see, I got on all my lovely gear because my Dolphins did a thing this Wednesday. They went in there and got the young man, Tyreek Hill, and we are excited. We are excited now. It cost us a little bit, but it cost them a lot of bit. $120 million and five draft picks and $120 million, I think, for something like a four-year extension, something to that nature, which brings me to what I want to speak on today. Family, what are you willing to sacrifice? What are you willing, not just for Lent, to give up in order to level up in your life? See, I think a lot of times, family, some of the things that we're holding on to is the very things that's holding us back. So just like the Dolphins, if you know my team, we never really go out there and spend that type of money. We really never go out there and get some of the top prospects. We try to get people that's later on in their career. But this time, we went out there and made the ultimate sacrifice. So I'm asking you again, what are you willing to give up? What are you willing to do right now, today, in your life that will make you that much more successful in your future? Are you willing to go back to school? Are you willing to get some certifications to make you more favorable for that next promotion? What are you willing to do? A lot of times, family, we get into, well, I don't want to do this. I don't want to do that. Pastor, you know, I don't come to church. I don't think that tithing or giving an offering is necessary. We have all these things in place that we're not willing to do. But what are you willing to do? What are you willing to give up? For example, something simple. I realized going into this new year, I was still kind of frivolous with my money. So I did one thing. I have this, all these K-Cups. I have me a Keurig machine. Why am I stopping at 7-Eleven every morning to get coffee, buying coffee, when I have coffee and all the necessities that I have right there in the house? So starting this week, started Monday, I just started making my own coffee, getting up, putting it in my routine, and that's saving me $2 a day. Now, you might say, Pastor, that ain't no big money, but it adds up. It adds up. So I'm telling you today, it's just do something small. Do something small that will help you down the road. I also don't mind sharing and being transparent. This is the first time because in the military, I didn't have to do it. But in the civilian sector, I started with my 401k. I was very proud of myself. I started 401k. I also started my Roth IRA. Now, sometimes what you do now, you won't get the instant gratification. But 10 years from now, the little monies that I put away, if I put that little $2 away, when I put that money I put away for my 401k and my Roth IRA, 59, 60, whatever time it's for retirement age, I have set myself up to live a good life for the rest of my life. Amen? Amen? Listen, family, start asking why. Why do I have to do this? Why should I do this? And start saying, why not? Why not? Why not, like I said, go back to school? Why not give church a try? Why not start tithing? We have to get that mindset to say, let me try. Let me do something out of the ordinary. Let me step out, because my Dolphins, they want to win now. In the near future, we're looking at big ventures, Super Bowl, playoffs, all that. So you got to make big sacrifices. With big sacrifices come big blessings. I'm very, very, very honed in, locked in, linked in, and I believe that to the core of my heart. Big sacrifices yields big blessings. Well, Pastor, show it to me. Show it to me biblically. Ruth gave up her stability. She gave up her family. She gave up everything that she knew to follow her mother-in-law to another homeland. The reward, as she put in all this work and went through the things that she went through, is that she became a queen. And she found her Boaz. But she had to make that sacrifice. That's good. But can you give me something a little bit more? Sure I can. Solomon made thousands of burnt offerings. Thousands. And his reward was, he was one of the wisest kings, the wisest kings that we ever known. And the ultimate gift and the ultimate sacrifice is God. John 3:16. So God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. Now, if that's not the ultimate sacrifice, family, I don't know what is. And not only the ultimate sacrifice, but the ultimate unselfishness. Because he gave his only begotten son for us. For us. So now that the deed has been done, the sacrifice has been made, now it's up to us to walk the path. We cannot be scared, family, to get out there on faith and make that big sacrifice, for we can walk in that big blessing. I'm not going to keep you long. Have a beautiful weekend on purpose. Remember, God loves you, and so do I. Be blessed.
You've been tuning in to Greater Grace Daily Programming. The church is located at 3709 Elliott Avenue, Portsmouth, Virginia. Join us for worship on Sundays at 10 a.m. and for Bible study Tuesdays at 7 p.m.
You can follow us on social media on Facebook and Instagram at 757 No Place Like Grace, and on YouTube by searching Greater Grace Portsmouth. To sow into this ministry, you can give via PayPal, paypal.me/greatergrace, or you can give through Givelify by searching Greater Grace Portsmouth, Virginia. We also have Cash App, $GGCWFA2009. And if you prefer mail, you can send all gifts and blessings to P.O. Box 13514, Chesapeake, Virginia 23325.
For more programming like this, join us Mondays via our conference call line at 7 a.m. for Motivational Monday, Refuge Night with Renewed Worship at 7 p.m. on Wednesdays, and Fire on Friday with Pastor Matt, Fridays at 9 a.m.
Thank you for listening. Our Bishop, Bishop James E. Jones Jr., and Leading Lady Lisa are grateful for your continued faithfulness. Remember, there's no place quite like grace because of the people in grace. And together, we are Grace Strong.